Halo minasan konnichiwa, xinchao, kumusta namaste, ni hao, annyeonghaseyo, hello guys. Yesterday, I already explained about attack tactical chip. And today, I'm going to explain about defense tactical chip. As usual, first, I'm going to divide the chip based on the tier. S tier, A tier, B tier, and C tier. S tier is the chip that you should try to get no matter what. They are absolutely strong. A tier means they are good and only overshadowed by S tier chip. B tier means the chip is very situational. They can be good, but not on most situation. C tier means the chip doesn't really have much effect, but still can be useful for something. First on S tier, we have Calm and Unhurried. Boost damage reduction by 1.3% after each damage taken. Stack up to 10 times. When you are on maximum stack, gain additional 1.5 armor. On level 1 max stack, you will get 13% damage reduction and 1.5 armor until you leave combat. This chip is seriously S tier for PvE and PvP. Next on S tier for PvE, we have melee defense. When taking damage from a unit within 120, increase your damage reduction by 8% and crit damage reduction by 5%. This is very good in that high when most of the enemy will be inside 120 range. This chip is S tier for PvE. Those are S tier for PvE. Now we moving on to A tier. We have Protection Expert. Yes, this free chip is on A tier. It's very good. It's just overshadowed by melee defense, even though in PvE crit damage is useless, but melee defense provides damage reduction without HP condition, whereas this chip will lose its effectiveness if you are low on HP. Next, we have Fully Armed. The only stat that we can use from this chip for PvE is the damage reduction. It provides 5.5% damage reduction, slightly lower than Protection Expert, but still better than most chip for PvE. Next, on A tier, we have Thorn Shield. This chip gives you 10% damage reduction when your shield still active. And when the shield is broken, it will deal 10% of shield limit as damage to enemy within 60 range. And it seems the shield damage is affected by food, antiseptic, even the gun you're holding. This shield could be better if only the range is more bigger. 60 range is this far, by the way. And also, it can only happen once in every 30 seconds. Not the best, but definitely not the worst. Those are for A tier. Now we moving on B tier for PvE. First, in B tier, we have counter attack armor. When attack, there is 10% chance to reduce attacker attack power by 2 for 5 seconds. In that high, this can be somewhat useful, but it's 10% chance. The reduce enemy attack power by 2 is not bad, but the 10% chance is bad. Next, on B tier, we have Fast Runner. This one is good for stages where you need to keep running or speed running, but that's pretty much about it. For boss stages, this chip is useless. Next, we have Defense Master. Boost your armor by 1 and damage reduction by 10% for 6 seconds. And restore your shield by 10% of your total damage taken within the duration. So when you get attacked, you will get 1 armor and 10% damage reduction. And 10% damage you get within that duration will convert it into shield regen. This chip is meh, but for those who don't have better chip as I mentioned before, you can use it. Next is Risky Move. Restore your shield equal 12% of your maximum shield, and boost your armor by 1.3 for 5 seconds when you are seriously injured. This can be somewhat good when you're dying. You get some shields and armor boost, but other chip can perform better than this one. Next, we have Iron Wall Defense. When damage received in single time exceeds 25% of your maximum HP, the damage will be additionally reduced by 10%. So if you have 1k HP and you get 300 damage, it will reduce the damage by 10%. Other chip can do better. That's all for B tier. Now we moving on C tier. First on C tier, we have Unyielding Defender. When HP is below 40%, damage reduction increased by 10%. Yeah bro, if your HP is below 40%, you will mostly heal yourself with drone, and that 10% damage reduction is gone. Next we have Anti-Explosion Expert. This chip can be A tier when zombies start using Biotihoi. Next we have Protection Awareness. Yeah, the only boost from this chip in PvE is that 60% damage reduction for 0.55 seconds. I think it won't even be enough to withstand one zombie. Next on C tier, we have Energetic. Yep, this chip is also useless for PvE. Next is Force Device. When HP is below 40%, there is chance to dodge attack by 8%. Yeah, in most situations, you will still be dead because the enemy still have 92% chance of hitting you. That's all for the PvE tier. Now we moving on PvP tier. Fully armored from A tier become S tier, because you can get 13% explosion damage reduction, 5.5% damage reduction, and if your shield still intact, additional 5.5% crit damage reduction. Really nice. Next, from B tier to A tier, we have Fast Runner. Mostly, we will always jump in life after when PvP, and when you jump, you get 10.5% damage reduction, which is a lot. Next, from S tier to A minus or B plus is melee defense, because melee defense in PvP is not that great, as you will get full damage from enemy further than 120 range. Definitely not B tier, but also not A tier. Now from a C tier to B tier, we have Anti-Explosion Expert. This chip is good for defending against Biotihoi, but that's it, it does not provide any reduction against other gun. Next, from C tier to B tier, we have Protection Awareness. Yeah, this is the most useless premium chip ever, because what it does is just give you headshot damage reduction. If enemy use flamethrower or Biotihoi or Zanbato or even shotgun and assault rifle, if they don't hit your head, this chip is garbage. So this is how it looks like for PvP tier list. Wish you all the best on the gacha. I hope you guys can get the best chip for everything. Hope this video helps. Thank you guys for watching. See you guys next time.